I am Sai. These are my batchmates. We are studying in Arche College of Engineering and Technology from Mechanical Branch. We are doing project on solar concrete flat plate collector.
One sixth of the total population, India occupies third largest in power consuming and fifth largest country in power generation. By using large amount of fossil fuels, there should be a scarcity in for future generation. Our future generation is depends upon solar energy. It is inexhaustible and eco-friendly. Solar energy is used in many ways. It is used for producing electricity, running vehicles, and for domestic heating water purpose. By using conventional flat plate collectors, the water is heated. These are high efficient, but these are very expensive. To reduce the costs, we are doing project on concrete solar flat plate collector. Coming to the specification, we use copper material because it have high thermal conductivity and it is very less cost when compared to the remaining materials. In this, the length of the copper tube is 2 meters, the width of the copper tube is 1 meter, the distance between two copper tubes is 10 centimeters, the diameter of the copper tube is 10 mm. In this, two headers are placed. The diameter of the header is 25 mm. In this, stopper is attached after the inlet to restrict the flow of the water. Coming to the project, concrete slab is placed inclined at an angle of 17 degrees. Copper tubes are embedded in this concrete slab. At the top of the concrete slab, black paint is coated because to absorb more amount of heat energy. At the bottom of the concrete slab, we are placing wood because wood is acts as an insulating material. Now from the storage tank, water is passed to the inlet. After the completion of process, the hot water is collected at the outlet of the tube.
This is the copper tubes which is enclosed in a concrete slab. For this copper tubes, there are 9 tubes. For this, from this 9 tubes, 2 are inlet and 7 are output.
When we give water flow to the input, the water flows from input to top header. There is a stopper here to restrict the water flow to the output. These 2 are input tubes. From these 2 input tubes, the water flows to the bottom header. From the bottom header, the water flows from the 7 output tubes. And finally reaches the top header. From top header, the water comes from output.